Hi divers, welcome back on my channel, thank you for being here. In this video, I show you a very inexpensive alternative to the Halcyon Flare EXP handheld primary light, the Sofirn SD01, and see how it compares to the Halcyon model, coming up. I think that the age of corded canister lights is going to come to an end with advancing battery technology. There is an increasing number of really good handheld primary lights in the market, like the Halcyon Flare EXP. I made a review about some time ago, the video is linked up in the corner. If you are subscribed to my channel for a while, and by the way, if you are not already subscribed, you should do now and never miss upcoming videos. Anyway, when you watch the review about the Halcyon handheld light, you know that I really like this light and I really recommended it. However, now I came across a very interesting light that, after some tiny adjustments, could work as a budget-friendly alternative, the Sofirn SD01 dive light, and this is it. The manufacturer approached me with the proposal to review this light specifically. Technically, I did not get it for free since I paid it with my own money. However, they gave me a 99% discount voucher for Amazon, so I don't want to hide the fact that I only paid less than 1 euro for it, so it was kind of for free. Anyway, I do not get any money for this video. I just put an affiliate link to Amazon in the description, so if you decide to buy the light after my review, you still pay the same price and I just get a small commission for the purchase. So from a first look, this light looks really sturdy. It's made from an aluminum alloy. Still, it feels pretty heavy and I can just measure the weight in comparison to the Halcyon light. So this light is, including batteries, 749 grams, while the Halcyon Flare EXP is 621 grams. So the Sofirn SD01 is a bit heavier than the comparable Halcyon light. The overall design is very similar, maybe you can see it. Anyway, I like the design Halcyon has and therefore I like the design of the SD01 too. However, this light has one very obvious design flaw and this is the handle. I don't know what this handle is made for. It's honestly too small to firmly grab the light and as a technical diver, I definitely want a Goodman handle. A Goodman handle enables me to use my hand and grab things like a regulator, a spool, a reel and so on. So without a Goodman handle, this light is kinda useless to me. But I'm prepared as always and I ordered a cheap Goodman handle alongside with this light. And of course, I need a bolt snap to attach it to the light to clip it off permanently. And I need some kind of rubber rope, as you can see here, and some zip ties to attach this to the light to clip it off, let's say during gas switches and so on. So let's make this light a nice dive light for technical divers. When you buy a Goodman handle, make sure that it has just one screw to attach to the Sofirn SD01, because as you can see with the Halcyon light, many manufacturers have several smaller screws to attach the Goodman handle, and in order to attach it to the Sofirn, you need one big hole in the center, and you should make sure that it has this cutout so that the Goodman handle does not interfere with the magnetic ring switch. Wow, much better. So with the Goodman handle attached, it really looks like a nice handheld light for technical divers. Now let's talk about the light itself. As I said before, the light is relatively heavy and a bit bulky since it is relatively short, which means the weight distribution is not as perfect as with, for instance, the Halcyon Flare EXP, which really feels very well balanced on the hand and you really feel the lesser weight. However, it's not horrible with the SD01, and underwater it does not feel too heavy or badly balanced. The attachment point on the rear for maybe a bungee cord is not really usable because the light would point downwards if attached here. It is preferred to have the light pointing slightly forward instead of directly downward during a gas switch or while shooting an SMB, for instance. That's the reason I attached the bungee cord with a zip tie more towards the middle. In a future version, I'd prefer to have a nice attachment point somewhere here, like the Halcyon Flare EXP has, as you can see. The light uses three LEDs, and according to the manufacturer, can emit up to 6,000 lumen on the highest setting. It's turned on and off with this magnetic ring switch, which I really like. Honestly, in comparison to lights with piezo switches or with the tiny lever on the Halcyon Flare, this is very easy to use even with really thick gloves. The light has four dim levels, and since the luminous flux does not really tell much because you don't want to know how much light the LED emits, but how much light illuminates a certain area in front of you, it makes more sense to specify the illuminance in lux. Since Sofirn doesn't give the lux values, I got myself a new toy, this lux meter. I know that measurements in this setting are not extremely comparable since I don't really have a standardized setup and this thing is relatively cheap and it's hard to measure LED anyway because of the narrow spectrum luminosity function. Come on, just let me play around with this. It's better than nothing. For comparison, I measure the Halcyon Flare EXP2, not because this was a side-by-side comparison, but it's the most comparable light to the SD01 I have. Halcyon claims the Flare EXP to have 11,000 lux in 1 meter of distance, so I have 1 meter of distance here and I measure the brightest part of the light beam in that distance. But to make it as comparable as possible, let me turn off all the lights first. You can see it's pretty dark in here. So first, let's measure the Halcyon light. Oh, that's better. The Halcyon light has, it's very hard to see. The Halcyon light has two dim levels and I measure first the low and then the high dim level. So let's have a look. The Halcyon light has 6,000 lux in 1 meter of distance on the low dim level. Now let's go for the high dim level. So this has 15,000 lux in 1 meter of distance. This is the high level. Now let's switch to the Sofirn SD01 on dim level low. The low level has 3,400 lux. Level 2 has 9,600. The third level has 30,200 lux. And the highest dim level, this is pretty brutal bright, really. The highest dim level has 95,000 lux. So let's switch on the lights. Much better. So in the end, I can say that the SD01 is brighter than the Halcyon light in total. The question is, who needs such a bright light in diving? Especially in cave environments, it's rather a problem that lights are often too bright. Still, if you dive with this light in a very bright environment, it's good to have a really bright light. Now, let's open the light and have a look at the power source. As you can see, the light is secured by two O-rings here, and Sofirn says its operational depth is up to 100 meters, which should be enough for most of the dives you do. Still, it looks so rugged, I think it could take even much more than 100 meters. But 100 meters is the depth Sofirn tells us. The power comes from four rechargeable 18650 batteries. It's lithium iron batteries. Each of them has 3 ampere hours at 3.7 volts, which makes 11.1 watt hours per cell. So flying should not be a problem in terms of energy content of the cells. Usually, airlines allow lithium ion cells up to 100 watt hours each to be taken on a plane. However, you should always check this in advance. Still, having replaceable batteries give you the opportunity to even fly without batteries and buy them locally if you prefer. Another advantage is that you can just buy another set of batteries and you can just exchange them in between dives and always use fully recharged batteries when doing multiple dives a day. A disadvantage is that bigger battery packs like used in the Halcyon Flare EXP or other handheld dive lights usually contain more energy, resulting in a much better burn time. The Halcyon Flare EXP, for instance, has a burn time of 2 hours on the highest dim level, but as I saw in my review of that light, even exceeds the manufacturer's specifications. Sofirn gives a burn time of 1 hour and 30 minutes on the highest level, 5 hours on high, 5 hours and 30 minutes on medium, and up to 20 hours on low. As always, I put it to a test, and I test the highest and the second highest dim level on the Sofirn SD01, because the second dim level is, I think, the closest to the Halcyon Flare EXP. It's a bit brighter than the high level on the Halcyon Flare EXP, but from what I saw on the water, the light beam seems to be comparable between the high dim level on the Halcyon and the second highest dim level on the Sofirn. The light has a low voltage warning. When the cell voltage drops below 3 volts, the LED starts to flash once every minute and the light itself reduces the brightness to save battery life. So you can really see when it hits that point of 3 volts per cell. Just see how the light performs. So the Sofirn SD01 really does what it should. The burn time on the highest level was 47 minutes. That's not great and less than Sofirn claims. However, you have to consider that on the highest dim level, the light is much brighter than the Halcyon Flare EXP, for instance. The usual setting I would use for the average open water dive would be dim level 3, the second brightest level. The usual setting I would use for the average open water dive would be dim level 3, the second brightest level. The burn time here was 3 hours and 40 minutes, which is less than the 5 hours Sofirn announced, but should be sufficient for most of the dives and is in the range of other lights. And the light dims down to level 1 after the cells reach 3 volts, so it does not leave you without light immediately. And you always have the opportunity to replace the batteries after every dive if you do multiple dives a day. The Sofirn SD01 is sold for 96 euros on Amazon in the EU and for $89 in the US. For this, you get the light for 18650 batteries, two chargers for the batteries, including the cables, and two spare O-rings. And quite frankly, this price is amazing. If you look for other comparable lights, you pay easily a couple of hundreds more. The Halcyon Flare EXP comes at around $800/euros, and there are some brands in between. The only thing I really recommend to change is the Goodman handle. But I paid for this handle something around 25 euros on Amazon, so let's say in total you get your hands on this amazing light for well under $130 or euros. Before I sum up this review, please make sure to hit the like button if you already took some value out of this video. On this channel, I do a lot of gear reviews like this one, but also instruction videos and vlogs about my dive trips. So please subscribe to my channel and ring the bell. By this, you never miss any upcoming videos. So what do I think about this light, the SD01 for technical divers? Is it the best performing handheld dive light in the market? No, it's not. You have to make some adjustments, like to add a Goodman handle. With the Goodman handle I got here, I cannot fold the light like I can with the Halcyon light. And then it really fits into my pocket. With the Goodman handle here, I used here, I cannot do it, but for sure, you could buy a foldable handle and use a foldable handle with this light too. Is the burn time mind-blowing? No, it's not. It's even less than the manufacturer claims, but it's okay for most of the dives, and it is well within the range other lights have. Is the weight distribution on the hand perfect? No, it's not. The Halcyon Flare EXP has a much better weight distribution, and the rear attachment point for the bungee leaves the light unbalanced when clipped away, so I had to fix the bungee with the zip tie in the middle. So this light is not the best handheld dive light I've ever used, but it's not the worst either. Overall, it does a quite decent job. It's really solid. It has a decent burn time. It's really bright if needed. In the end, it's a nice dive light. You could really make use of this light even in a bit more advanced forms of diving. And for the price of one Halcyon Flare, you could buy almost 6 to 8 of these lights. And even if it was only half as good as the Halcyon light, it's just a fraction of the price, and this makes this light, in my opinion, really, really awesome. So, especially if you're a beginner or you don't own any GUI-style dive equipment yet, and you start to scratch things together for a GUI fundamentals class, for instance, and you are not willing to spend 500 or 1000 bucks or even more for a light, the Sofirn SD01 is literally made for you. The overall performance is very good, and you get this for literally no money compared to other manufacturers' lights. And who knows, maybe in a future version they produce this light with a Goodman handle and maybe an attachment point for a bungee cord, which I'd really appreciate. Still, I'm very happy to have this light, and I was honestly very impressed by the performance. They really made a great job with this light. Maybe I get a foldable Goodman handle for this and use it as primary backup light or something like that. So what do you think? Would you buy this light or rather save up and buy one of the premium brands? Please leave me a comment and tell me. Give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and ring the bell and watch my other videos. See you there.